The Emergency Ordinance to Act Against Fake News is a short-term remedy to deal with misinformation concerning COVID-19 and the Emergency Proclamation, and not a tool to silence the people. Communications and Multimedia Minister Datuk Saifuddin Abdullah said the law was only meant to handle fake news so it does not cause panic and concern among the public.
Ordinance ini bertujuan untuk mempercepatkan proses penguatkuasaan, penyiasatan dan pendakwaan. Manakala prosiding di mahkamah kekal seperti sedia ada, di mana prosedur di bawah Kanun Tata Cara Jenayah, yakni Akta 593, kekal dan tidak berubah.
Minister in the Prime Minister's Department, Datuk Seri Takiyuddin Hassan, who was also present at the joint press conference, agreed that the ordinance is only a short-term measure as it will end once the emergency is lifted. He pointed out that the ordinance clearly stated an interpretation of what fake news means.
Berita tidak benar ini, senang saja. Berita tidak benar ini termasuklah tiga perkara. Satu, apa-apa berita. Yang kedua, apa-apa maklumat. Yang ketiga, apa-apa data dan laporan sama ada keseluruhannya ataupun sebahagiannya adalah palsu. Berkaitan dua perkara saja. Satu, COVID-19. Yang kedua, proklamasi darurat. Dia boleh datang dalam pelbagai bentuk, various form. Satunya rencana, artikel. Yang keduanya visual. Yang ketiganya rakaman audio. Atau apa-apa bentuk lain yang boleh menggambarkan perkataan atau idea itu.
Takiyuddin also explained that the fine imposed cannot exceed RM100,000 and it would be up to the discretion of the judge to determine an appropriate amount. The Emergency Bracket Essential Powers Bracket Number 2 Ordinance 2021 took effect on March 12. The ordinance also states that the law applies to any person involved in the dissemination of fake news, both within the country and abroad, regardless of nationality, given that the fake news in question affects Malaysia or a Malaysian citizen.